As we have been reporting, the yield on the 10-year Treasury note has fallen to levels we have not seen since September of 2017. Now that means lower mortgage and auto loan rates and a renewed interest in personal loans. Joining us to talk about all that tonight is Greg McBride. He's Chief Financial Analyst at Bankrate. Greg, good to see you, and thanks for joining us tonight.
Thanks for having me, Bill.
Personal loans, they've become more popular in part because of the lower rates, but also tax changes have made them more attractive as well, right?
Yeah, on a relative basis. The tax law really changed the deductibility of interest on home equity loans. And so people that are looking at, having to put a new roof on or, they need to, they need $10,000, $20,000, $30,000 and they need it quick. Personal loans have become an attractive way to do that because, you can apply online and have that money deposited into your account within 48 hours. And for people with good credit, they're finding rates that are comparable to what they'd otherwise get on a home equity loan, but without the whole process of an appraisal, waiting 30 days to have your closing, and then a three-day rescission period before the funds are dispersed. So on a relative basis, right, the personal loans really stand out.
But this is a low interest rate environment. What if that starts to change?
Yeah, I think the real risk here, Sue, is that when the economy slows, we are going to see delinquencies and defaults really surging on unsecured debt, credit cards, and personal loans, particularly those that were made to consumers with marginal or weak credit. For now, there's a lot of competition among lenders, primarily for the consumer who has really strong credit. Those are the borrowers that can get rates in the mid-single digits. For borrowers that are riskier, we're already seeing lenders pull back a little bit.
Who are the lenders? I mean, if I want to get a home equity loan, I go back to the mortgage company. Where do I get the personal loan? Do I go to a bank or where do I go?
This is a product that banks have long offered, but they really didn't focus on. And some banks that even owned finance companies long ago shuttered those. And so what we're seeing is a lot of what you might call fintechs that have come into the space. The people like SoFi, Avant, entities like that, that they're not necessarily banks, but with the advent of technology, they've developed a way to get money in people's hands very quickly and very easily.
And these are generally shorter term loans than, say, a typical home equity, correct?
Yes. A lot of this is going to depend on how much you borrow. But, generally, these are 3 to 5 year loans, maybe a little bit more if you're borrowing more money. But that's also why we're not seeing the rates come down like we are, say, with mortgage rates over the last few weeks. The long-term rates plunging, that's brought mortgage rates down to the lowest levels since 2017. Not the case with the personal loans because they're more closely tied to short-term rates.
Greg McBride with Bankrate. Again, thanks for joining us tonight, Greg.
Thanks for having me.